Hello everyone. Welcome back. Let's talk Software Inc. If you haven't already caught wind of the news, the update is closer than ever. With the version number being switched from Alpha 11.8 to Beta 1, I'm sure it's going to be the biggest yet. In fact, it is. About a week ago, I got the chance to speak with a developer of Software Inc., Kenneth. He told me a whole bunch of stuff regarding the latest update, and was all around really generous with giving this much information to me, so Kenneth, if you're watching this, thank you. Let's get to the details. The three main features that we know of now are overhauled employee hiring and trades, hardware design, and of course, updates and expansions. Luckily, we know quite a bit of the details of what's coming. We also know that most of the Alpha 11 mechanics will stay. Let's start with the all-new hardware design. It's a pretty unique gimmick that'd be nice for immersing yourself into your company. A hardware design consists of a bunch of objects that you can add onto one main mesh with the help of attachment points. In hindsight, it's pretty simple. You just put a D-pad and some buttons onto the face of the controller, along with a few handles at the bottom of it. Of course, it's not only controllers. It's every hardware type, and it's even moddable. I personally can't wait to see how the phones will be done. In addition to that, you will be able to show off your hardware in your own office on shelves. That's all we really know about hardware design. If you want to know more, you can check the wiki page for it. Note that it isn't finished. Alright, now on to the overhauled employees. We don't really have a lot of information regarding this. All we have is this screenshot and a short explanation. With the overhauled employee hiring system, you can now hire employees with filters that match your priorities. And in addition to that, the game will only refresh the selection of applicants every month, and only charges you if new applicants appear. This saves you from losing out on that perfect employee you were just about to hire. Now the employee trades. There's not really much known about them, except that we know three of them are called Big Brain, Neat Freak, and Night Owl, but we can notice that those very icons are colored accordingly to designers, programmers, and artists. This may suggest that these traits will be tailor-made for certain positions. Okay, now on to the subscription services, expansions, and of course, updates. The subscriptions are pretty self-explanatory. Every month, the customer pays for a service, or in this case, product. The expansions, though, are not too easy to puzzle together. I suppose you're going to be able to add new features to the base software with these. And finally, the updates. Kenneth has stated that the updates themselves will be a somewhat minor feature. Of course, I'm sure we all doubt that. With updates, you won't fix bugs using the support task anymore, you'll actually have to release patches with fixes. In addition to that, you can also update the technology level of certain categories of your software using updates. Overall, updates will keep active users for longer, which will be very necessary for subscription services, and will equally help sell expansions. The updates should roll out onto the testing branch anywhere around 2 to 9 months. So, that's it. There's all you should know regarding what's coming in the next update for Software Inc. I'll see you next time, in September. This has been your August briefing. Goodbye.